In this video, you'll see how to improve application performance with Amazon CloudWatch application signals. With this feature, you can automatically instrument your applications on AWS so you can track their performance against business objectives and prioritize incident response. This is the Amazon CloudWatch console. To get started, let's look at how to enable application signals. First, we need to specify the platform of our application services. We can choose Amazon Elastic Kubernetes Service or a custom platform. In this case, we'll keep EKS selected and specify an existing EKS cluster. Note that the CloudWatch Observability EKS add-on has been successfully created. This add-on is required to send telemetry data to CloudWatch. To configure application metrics and trace sampling, we must add the following annotation to the application workload or namespace manifest. The addition of the annotation will cause the OpenTelemetry Java auto instrumentation library to be automatically injected into the specified services. This allows us to get started without making any changes to our application code. We've already enabled application signals for our EKS cluster, so we'll click Cancel. Once enabled, application signals automatically collects metrics and traces from applications. This page provides an overview of key metrics, including top operations and dependencies by volume, fault, and latency. It also shows the status of service level indicators that have been configured for our application services. Next, let's open the service map to inspect our application topology. We'll zoom out to view the full topology. Two of our services have an unhealthy SLI status. Let's drill into one of the service nodes. The pane summarizes key information about the service, including service level objectives and associated SLIs, service operations and dependencies, and any Amazon CloudWatch synthetics or real user monitoring pages. Let's return to the services page to see how we can further investigate our unhealthy services. We can quickly view the unhealthy SLIs for each service. Let's drill into the pet clinic front-end service to get more information. The service detail page is organized into four tabs. The service operations tab displays a list of the operations our service exposes, along with key metrics for each operation. Let's select the operation for scheduling pet visits. The charts update accordingly. Notice that the first chart shows some drops in availability. Let's select a point on the graph where the availability drops to investigate the root cause. In the pane, we can see the correlated traces. Let's drill into one to learn more. This page displays a map of service nodes involved in the selected trace, along with a timeline of trace segments. Let's view additional information about this request made to DynamoDB. Here we can see the exception that caused the request to fail. For applications running on EKS that use CloudWatch Container Insights, we can get additional performance monitoring metrics by selecting any link in the Hosted In column. This view is automatically filtered for the EKS pod that processed the transaction. CPU and memory utilization metrics can help identify issues occurring outside of the application, like infrastructure problems, that might have caused the request to fail. In this case, everything looks normal. Let's return to the service details page for the pet clinic front-end service and look at the remaining tabs. The dependencies tab displays metrics for the dependencies that the service calls. This table shows the operations called for each dependency. The Synthetics Canaries tab shows information about canaries that call the service. Note that to see canaries in application signals, X-ray active tracing must be enabled. We can select a canary to troubleshoot why it failed. In a single click, we're able to see the canary traces that are correlated to the data point we selected. In this case, they help us understand why the operation for creating an owner was unavailable. The final tab displays a list of client pages that call the service, along with client page metrics to help us assess the web app's performance. Again, we can drill into any of the charts to get more details. Note that CloudWatch Real User Monitoring and X-ray Active Tracing must be enabled to view these metrics. Next, let's look at how to create SLOs. SLOs can be used to track the longer-term performances of services to ensure they're meeting expectations. Let's create one now. In this example, we'll create an SLO to monitor the availability of the service used to schedule a pet visit. First, we'll provide a name. Next, we'll set an SLI to determine whether we are meeting our SLO goal. We can select a custom CloudWatch metric, or we can simply select a service operation from a discovered service. In this case, we'll do the latter. Next, we'll set the condition. In this case, an availability greater than 99% in a 1-minute period indicates success. Next, we'll set the SLO to define the reliability of our service against customer expectations. The interval establishes how much time we have before we need to respond to these events and assess the reliability of the service. In this case, we'll set the interval to 28 rolling days. We'll leave the attainment goal at 99.9%. Next, we'll set CloudWatch alarms to receive notifications for important events related to this SLO goal. The SLO and CloudWatch alarms have been successfully created. Now we can monitor our SLO's attainment rate, error budget, and other metrics from this list page to see if they are meeting the goals. You've just seen how to improve application performance with CloudWatch application signals. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.